heart said unto my Lord, Thou art my right hand, till I make thine enemies thy footstool. The Lord shall send thee a rod of strength out of Zion. With thee there is dominion in the day of thy power, in the beauties of the saints.
Blessed is the entrance of the holy things, now that we are in the day of ages. Amen. Wisdom, let us attend. Minerva, Nika, Milko, Kalisa, Hay, Walla, Tuka, Anna, Farapo, Walla, Yale, Anna, Anta, Kahinu, Ileda, Aleda, Tibu, Man, she said, from the womb before the morning star begotten thee, the Lord has sworn he will not repent. Thou art a priest forever according to the order of Melchizedek.
Thank you.
When the time had fully come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. And because you are sons, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son, and if a son, then also an heir of God through Jesus Christ.
Jamil al-Ardi tazura katura tibula katura tibuli ismika. جاء ملء الزمان أرسل الله ابنه مولودا من امرأة مولودا تحت الناموس ليفتدي الذين تحت الناموس لننال التبني ثم بما أنكم أبناء أرسل الله روح ابنه إلى قلوبكم صارخا يا أبا الآب إذا لست بعد عبدا بل ابنا وإن كنت ابنا فوارث لله
чтение. Но когда пришла полнота времени, Бог послал Сына Своего Единородного, который родился от жены, подчинился закону, чтобы искупить подзаконных, дабы нам получить усыновление. А как вы сыны, то Бог послал в сердца ваши Духа Сына Своего, вопиющего «Авва, Отче!» Посему ты уже не раб, но сын. А если сын, то и наследник Божий через Иисуса Христа. Аллилуйя, аллилуйя, аллилуйя.
Prophet, and thou Bethlehem, the land of Judah, art not the least among the prince of Judah,
out of thee shall come a covenant that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod went yet quickly, called the wise men, inquired them diligently what time the star appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search diligently for the young child, and when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. And when they had heard the king, they departed, and both the star which they saw in the east went before them to the cave and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were coming to the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother. They fell down and worshipped him. When they had opened their treasures, they presented him in gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned of God and truth, they should not return to Herod. They departed to their own country. Another way.
Thank you. Wherefore we implore thee, O Lord, our heavenly gracious, and look down upon us sinners, thine imperfect servants, and cleanse our souls and our hearts with evil conscience by the power of the Holy Spirit, and enable me to endure with the grace of the priesthood, to stand before this thy holy table, and perform the second mystery of thy holy act of body and physical. For we draw near to thee and bow on our necks, we pray thee, turn not thy face from us, neither cast us out from among thy children, but thou say that these gifts may be offered unto thee by us, thy simple and worthy servants, without thyself be he that offers. They accepted the distribute of Christ our God, and to thee, Christ our Lord, hear that Father was blessed with good and life and spirit, now and ever, unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Patrick, Monk Augustine, Nelvis Andrew, Choir, Tracy John, Daniel Mark, Stephen Dennis, David Nikolai, Kevin, Jason, Isaac, Alex, Adam, Alina, Gary, Divina, Irene, Cindy, Ruthen, Lisa, Anatoly, Olga, James, Artek, Paul, Louis, Mike, Susan, David, Dimitri, Rima, Angelina, Andrew, George, Sabros, Nicola, Maria, Johnny, Claudius, Maria, Megan, Harry, and Christine, Andre, Anna, Kirill, Amelia, Olga, Mike, Medina, Julia, Valerie, Constantine, Nadezhda, Alex, Nikolai, Diana, Leanne, Michael, Susan, Curtis, Challenge, Jenny, David, Julie, Felix, Lance, Rubina, Chris, Paul, Luna, Lorraine, Edna, Jean, Leonard, Andrew, Taj, Ava, Suzanne, Dicky, Mary, Good, Teresa, Rebecca, Monsoor, Abla, Layan, Gabby, Virgin, Monique, Marie, Antoinette, Jacob, Anastasia, Clinton, Alexandra, Adelaide, Micah, Michelle, Zina, Evgenia, Constantine, Evgenia, Yuri, Edward, Julia, Marina, Robert, Lenore, Larry, Alexander, Alexandra, Eric, Marcia, Audrey, April, Gordon, Andrew, Antonella, Arthur, Sophia, Sasha, Yuri, Victoria, Stephanie, Ivan, Evgeny, Jeremy, Yvonne, Solange, Stephen, Patricia, Wilma, all seven of this band that are going to argue some more in Syria and Armenia, all homeless and giving up faith in the sanctuary of the Orthodox Church. May the Lord God remember them in his kingdom always, now and ever, and up to the ages of ages.
Mercy on us.
I will love the Lord my strength, the Lord my firm foundation, my refuge and my deliverer. I will love the Lord my strength, the Lord my firm foundation, my refuge and my deliverer. Send down the Holy Spirit upon us and among the gifts of His great glory. And make this bread the precious body of Thy Christ.
Amen.
And that is the consecration of Thy Christ.
Amen.
Changing them by the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Blessed Lord, the Lord has heard that we always now and ever to be in
for the Holy Prophet and Baptist John, the all holy apostles who we celebrate this day, the Lord's supplication of Israel so far. May be mindful, Lord, of those who are seeking us in the hope of resurrection and return, especially patriarchs of Elias and the nation of God. Metropolitan Philip, Archbishop Michael, Bishop Andrew Coon, Archbishop Warren, Gregory, Archbishop McKean, Earl McKean, David, Isaac, Michael, Joseph, Hannah, and Dimitri. Reverend Nicholas, Priest Alexander, Archdeacon David, Deacon Stenman, Cooper Mine James, Abigail, Evelyn, Karen, Carol, Martha, Sandra, Lord, Arthur, Alexander, Tatiana, Alexei, Maria, Alexandra, Latime, Matrina, Pania, Antonina, Ole, Catalina, Nona, Nadezhda, Alexander, Dalgar, Nicole, Santine, Vladimir, Jadir, Sugi, Nan, of myself that the rain built in the deep, in the rain that came tonight, Tony, Mahanas, Edgar Douglas, all those who battled in this pandemic, and all the bodies of St. George Orthodox Church, and grant them rest of our lives, like I was much over there. And again, we receive these minds of our own Bishop and Orthodox, like the Word of Legend, all the presbytery, the act of Christ, of your higher right and master for them. And again, we put these ritual worship for all. Those who have been chanting to God in your life, all civil powers, and all positive who have met them over a peaceful time, create their tranquility, make it a calm and peaceful life with all reverence and godliness. Among the first we mind from Lord Metropolitan Joseph, Grace Bishop Nicholas, who for that well of which much in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, and guiding you by your word of thy truth.
Thank you.
Giving, O Lord, all my transgressions. The presence of Almighty God and our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ is imparted to me and unworthy priest John.
Lord, have mercy.
faith and his love for him.
God, Father, Shatan. Thank you.
you and I already stand and we stand for the final elevation of your child to our Lord Christ. Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Take up the Lord, all your cause, that you can pray along with us.
Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O God. I thank thee, O Lord my God, that thou hast not rejected me, a sinner, but hast accounted me worthy to become a communicant of the holy mystery. I thank thee that thou hast accounted me, the unworthy, worthy to partake of thine immaculate and heavenly gifts. But, O Master, who lovest mankind, who didst both die for us and rise again, and didst bestow upon us these, thy terrible and life-giving mystery, for the benefit and sanctification of our souls and bodies. Grant that they may be for me also as the healing of soul and body, unto the averting of everything contrary thereto, unto the enlightenment of the eyes of my heart, unto the peace of my spiritual powers, unto faith invincible, unto love unfeigned, unto fulfilling of wisdom, unto the keeping of thy commandments, unto growth in thy divine grace, in the attainment of thy kingdom, that by them, preserved in thy holiness, I may ever remember thy grace, and henceforth live not unto myself, but unto thee, our Master and Benefactor. And thus, when this life is ended, in the hope of eternal life, I may attain unto everlasting rest, where the voice of those who keep festival is unceasing, and the light of those who behold the ineffable beauty of thy countenance is boundless. For thou art the true desire and unutterable joy of those who love thee, O Christ our God, and all creation in thee forever. Amen. May thy holy body, O Lord Jesus Christ our God, be unto me for life eternal, and thy precious blood unto remission of my sins. May this Eucharist be unto me for joy, health, and gladness, and at thy dread second coming make me, a sinner, worthy to stand at the right hand of thy glory, through the intercessions of thine all-immaculate Mother and of all thy saints. Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O Christ, our God and our hope. Glory to thee. Amen.
Good evening. Merry Christmas. It's this wonderful time of year that we show our appreciation and love for our priest. We take up a special collection for him now and in Costa. So give generously, show your love. Thank you very much. And we'll see you down the stands after the sermon.
name of the Father, and His Spirit. Lord, we thank you for this blessed day. We who have kept and attempted to keep the real spirit of this holy season in our hearts, show our love to you, the Lord, the love that you give to us. I pray, Lord, you give the words that will inspire all of us to be motivated to live our lives towards your love and grace. You the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please remain standing. This is a little tradition of ours in this holy church. Please stand and sing with me.
Happy birthday to you.
Most Russian people you would meet would be Orthodox.
when they built it, they were trying to show the Byzantines that they were on the same level as them. And it was built after the Roman church separated from the church. But it looks very much like an Orthodox church. And when I was in Venice, I told this story before, during the week the cruise ships come in, you have a line so long trying to get in to see the church at St. Mark. But on Sunday, when they close it for a few hours so that they can have their mass, there are 25 or 30 people up there. That's the story of St. Mark's. That's the story of Western Christianity. So in Western Christianity, they might ask, where is he? Where is Jesus? And what we've done in the West is we have reduced Jesus to more of a mental exercise of trying to figure out something which is right there before us. We Orthodox, we don't get into these things. And it's interesting to note that, of course, you know, the origin of the Orthodox Church, culturally speaking, the church was first under the aegis of the Greek language, the Hellenic world. And the Greeks were great for postulating and figuring out this and that, and I'd say Aristotle, Socrates, Plato, all these people were trying to figure out the real meaning of what life is all about. And they always came to a main point in the pagan period because it was only so far they could go. One of the reasons that the Hellenes so took to Christianity is because in Christianity there was no omega, there was no end point. It was open, and therefore all those questions about the origin of life, the meaning of life, why we're supposed to be here, was answered in the church. So the Greeks took this, and they expounded on it, and they emphasized it, and that is why in the Orthodox world, we don't have this question. But in the Western world, the world in which we live, we may be Eastern Orthodox, but we live in a Western society. And in this society, people are always looking and questioning, could it be this, could it be that? And we have all sorts of, not only religion, we have all sorts of philosophical thinking that is way beyond. And sometimes I know that my friend Nalos Andrew, he has a church over in Germany, he gets some very interesting questions from people about what's going on in the world. People are searching. Even the people that say they don't believe in God, they are searching. We are always searching. And I will tell you, after all the years the Lord has blessed me, I am still searching, but I'm not searching for this, I'm searching for how deep I can get into Jesus Christ. Because everything else is just a waste of time. Quite often, especially when I'm sitting with clergy of non-Orthodox backgrounds, some of them tell me, oh, did you read the book by so-and-so, or such-and-such, or this or that? And I say, no, I didn't read it. Oh, you must read it. I said, why must I read it? What is there possible that I can benefit from reading this book? This is written by somebody who doesn't know the Orthodox Church. And if you don't know the Orthodox Church, I'm not that interested in it. Oh, well, you just don't want to open your mind. You're right. I do not want to open my mind to heresy. I do not want to open my mind to that which is untrue. I do not want to open my mind to that which will mislead people. Yet, in this day of technology, constantly, you have a phone, you have a computer, it's being thrown at you over and over and over and over again. It could be this, it could be that, it could be the other thing. We live in a time of what we call fake news. But fake news has always been with us. It goes back to the resurrection. In fact, it goes back even further to the birth of Jesus. Herod sent his killers to kill all the children in Bethlehem that were 2 years age or old or younger. And I'm sure they came back and told the king, we got it all. Fake news. They didn't get Jesus. At the resurrection, we killed him, and his followers stole his body. Fake news. Point is that we need to be able to discern between fake and real news. And the real news always comes from Christ and the church. You might say that's a very narrow perspective. It is. It is. Because truth in our times is very, very narrow, and lies and misunderstandings and all the things that befuddle people are very, very wide. It goes on, it says in verse 6, and thou Bethlehem, the land of Judah, are not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor
that shall rule my people Israel. When the baby Nachman or the Yehuza Lesti Asura, Mayan or Asari, Yehuza, the enemy, Yorfu, Yorhuju, Mudemito, Yorashabi Israel. Of all the churches in America, I remember, if you have ever studied some of the great luminaries of American Orthodoxy, one of them was definitely Father Alexander Schmemann. Father Alexander, in his focus of peace, came from the Russian community in Paris. Father Alexander was a teacher at St. Vladimir's Seminary up in New York State. Father Alexander, one of his famous quotes was that Orthodoxy is the best kept secret in America. The best kept secret in America. And we quite often continue to make it a secret. How? We don't stand for, well, this is the church and that's it. Oh, well, you know, we want to get along with everybody. I want to get along with God. I want to get along with God. And if in my wanting to get along with God, that upsets some people, for that I'm sorry, God, I want to get along with God. So in America, the Orthodox Church is growing. I remember when I was a child, back when I first became a priest, this is a true story. I want to tell you the true stories anyway. I had a white robe on, the gold cross. Someone asked me what I was. I said, I'm Orthodox. They said, I did not know that Jewish people were supposed to wear crosses. I said, excuse me. They said, you said you're Orthodox. I said, yes, try with me. They said, well, Orthodox Jew, right? I said, no, Orthodox Christian. Didn't know what Orthodox meant anymore. As time went on, if people asked what I was, because that time the Soviet Union still existed. So instead of saying I was Russian Orthodox, it's more Russian Orthodox than they were Greek Orthodox, I would tell people I'm Greek Orthodox. I love this pretty much. They would say to me, you don't look Greek. I said, what does Greek look like? I don't know what Greek looks like. And then of course, with the collapse of the Soviet Union, I would tell people I'm Orthodox. They say, like, I said, like Russian Orthodox. But the point is that in America, still to this day, Orthodoxy may appear as little and the least of all churches. But its holy teachings can properly rule our lives. Everything else has failed. Why is America where it is today? Why? Why is America, the land of the free, a country that still many people, I don't know why they think this, they don't study, I mean, people don't study history. America was never founded as a Christian country. You need to know this. Yes, the founders of this country were almost all Christians. But America has a tenet that is a separation of church and state. This is not England. England is ostensibly a Christian country. France is ostensibly a Christian country. They have a state religion there. Greece, well, let's say Western Europe. Italy has a state religion. But in America, we don't have a state religion. So this is a country that was founded by Christians, but it's not a Christian country. But I can tell you, having lived through the, did you live through the 50s and 60s? Did you live through the 40s? When I was a child, everybody knew what they were. I grew up in Brooklyn, New York. I was very proud to have grown up in Brooklyn, New York. Everybody knew what they were. Everybody knew that they were this religion or that religion. Jewish people went to synagogues, Protestants went to Protestant churches, Roman Catholics went to Roman Catholic churches, Orthodox went to Orthodox churches. Everybody knew what their ethnicity was. I don't think you experienced that because you grew up down here. Okay, but when I grew up in New York, let me see, you know, I don't see anybody else here from New York. When I grew up in New York, everybody was an ethnicity. You could go to somebody and say, what are you? They would tell you, I'm Greek, I'm Russian, I'm Irish, I'm Italian, I'm Lebanese, whatever. When I first came here back in 1973, believe me, Angel, I'm so naive. So I went to some Bibles, you know, and I slept more. I said, what are you? He said, American man, what the heck do you think I am? I said, well, I don't know, what's your background? He says, Alabama. You know what I was talking about? Did you grow up with that? Did you ask people what they were, and they told themselves that they were Russian? Okay. But down here, they didn't have that. So when I was a child, the lines were very clearly drawn. We knew who we were. But today, we don't know who we are. We live in a country that doesn't know what they are. The only people that seem to know who they are in America are Hispanic people. There's a couple that came to church today. I thought I said, why you're from Mexico? They said that they're from Venezuela. But other Spanish people, I don't find that many people that actually know what they are. So if we don't have that identity, and here we are, the Orthodox Church, and my friend George Curry knows is coming from Lebanon. You know, the most people get on with everybody wants to be Orthodox. The Orthodox say, well, I'm not Orthodox, and didn't. We are blessed. I want you to remember this. We are very greatly blessed to be members of the Orthodox Church. We've been in this building since 1976. I can keep you here well into past 12 o'clock, telling you all the miracles that Jesus Christ has bestowed on this church since 1976. Some of it you would believe, some of it you think that I was hallucinating, I'm not. Christ has chosen this church to be in this place for a particular purpose. So we are the people, we talk about, he says, they will govern my people Israel. How are we to be governed? By the teachings of our church, and by living, not just knowing them, but by living those teachings. This is very, very important. You might think, well, I'm not sure. No, you really need to know these things. You need to know what the church teaches, because the teachings of the church will lead you to a better life. And when you break those teachings, when you don't follow those teachings, you need to understand that God is not looking to punish you. God is not angry. He's weeping, because he knows what is the best thing for you and for me, and he wants that for just like a parent. I want the best for my children, whether you're my physical children or my spiritual children. This is what I have struggled all these years in this church, because I want what is best for our children. And when we deviate from what the Lord wants for us, then we find ourselves in deep trouble. Finally, it says in verse 11, and when they were coming to the house, they saw the young child with Mary's mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened the treasure, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Now this is the season of gifts. I already have received what I wanted. People so often they're so kind and say, Father John, what would you like for Christmas? I very rarely can give an answer. Why would I give an answer when I already have what I wanted for Christmas? Number one, my physical family, speaking about myself, my physical family are together. My church family, especially the newest ornaments, newest ornaments, you see this beautiful church. This beautiful tree that is placed here. It takes one of those ornaments that are on this church, on this tree. Ryan Long, Tracy Edwards, Navas Andrew, John Flora, Jeremy Fontaine, Megan Sossaman, Alex Soloway, and all the new members of this church that have come in 2021. These are ornaments on this tree. But my friend Alex Rodolosco, his favorite ornament is his wife Sophia, that God had given to him in 2021. Now we know that the Magi gave gifts, frankincense, myrrh, and gold, and most people would be interested in the gold, but they have a meaning. The frankincense was for a god, because you offer incense to God. The gold is for a king, because Christ is our king. The mirror is to foretell the vividness of what will be the physical end of our Lord's earthly ministry. But remember the incense, because the incense is very fleeting. We send the incense, but what happens with incense, and let me ask my friend Gabrielle, when we send the incense, and you see the incense coming out, how long is the incense visible? It's just, it goes away. You know, in Greek they have an expression, pizza, which means that if you blow smoke, it's gone. So that incense does not last long. And why do we use incense? Because we're offering a sweet smelling to the Lord. But the incense does not last. But of all the things that they could have brought to you, they brought an incense, something that does not seem to last. What makes the incense last are the prayers that accompany it, if you really mean what you say when you offer up the incense. This may be the only Orthodox church that when I come out with the censer, I hold it up like this. Because on behalf of all of you, I am offering this incense to God, this sweet smelling scent. But it only lasts, it's only meaningful, if the prayers that accompany it are sincere. That is why I am so opposed to cell phones being on in the church. Because the cell phone distracts you from the prayer. And what distracts you from the prayer is always the devil. So a lot of people would spend so much time and joy wrapping gifts. Believe me, you don't want me to ever wrap a gift for you. I won't say which, but one of my sons last year, I love this, as he was giving his gifts to his family, he would give a gift and he'd take the paper back. And then he'd wrap the next gift in the same paper. I said, I thought I was there. My idea of wrapping gifts is enough scotch tape. But that gift, when you get it, when Teresa and Rebecca received their presents from the mother and father, when Kevin and Jason received their presents from their mother and father, when Chris and Danielle's children received their presents from their caregiver, from their mother and father, and all the gifts, remember one thing. The only little person that knows where they are today is my wife, Monique. The gifts you'll get are just in honor to Jesus Christ. And you need to remember that. Because you don't deserve the gift. The simple reason is you already have the gift. Right, George? You already got the gift. She's sitting next to me. Yeah, this Sunday we're going to join this man, this very lovely lady. We're going to have a wedding. This showed me the strength of the church. Because they didn't have to get married, they wanted to get married, and they wanted to get married in this church. So in reality, for Christmas, for me, and hopefully for you, the Lord received our gift, and that gift Jesus Christ, and the Father, and the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Thank you.
Sister Immaculate Holy Mother, by the power of which that people call spectrum on his power of heaven, supplicates the glory of the Father to our most holy Mother, as by St. George, Holy Girl, Peyton, St. Lord, Church, and Jump, but very Father, St. John, Christian, whose marriage is over to the Joachim and all things. Have mercy upon us, Savior, for as much as good, and love us mankind.
Bless us all, Lord, for the work of peace, and to this day, and always.